SYJCC TV, the show that lets you know what's going on at the Suffolk Y.
Hi everybody, it's me again, Rick Lewis, the CEO of the Suffolk Y-JCC. We're nearing the end of our summer, and I will tell you, it's really, really been a great one. It's nice to be open again. It's nice to have people coming in our doors. We're doing everything that's requested and required of us. We're taking temperature by the front door. We're asking all the required questions, and people walk in and feel very, very comfortable when they're here. Our pool has been open and very active, six lap lanes a day. And you know, it's been a lot of fun. We've had great camp programs going this summer. We have been feeding more people than we've ever fed before, both prepared meals and providing them with food from our food pantry. Again, great stuff. And I have to say over and over again, we could not do this without your support. We depend on your support and we are grateful for your support. So thank you very, very much for thinking about us, for caring about us. And we look forward to expanding our services as soon as we possibly can. And great stuff is on the wing, so please go to our website, talk to your neighbors about us, let everybody know how great we are, and please, please, please visit us as soon as you possibly can. Thank you.
Good morning, I'm Miss Amy from the Suffolk Y-JCC's Early Learning Center, and we are standing outside our infant and toddler hallway right in front of our security doors that only grants access to our teachers and our staff to keep our children safe. Let's take a look and see what's happening inside today. All right, now we're outside one of our four-year-old classrooms. We are on day four of our new school year, and we have 75 children in the center. We are so happy to have them back. They are having a great start. They are going to be working on their handwriting this school year, journaling. We have an all new UPK curriculum for this age group, and all of the teachers are doing a wonderful job right now. This class is doing morning meeting.
Good morning, room 17. Good morning, room 17. It's time to say hello. Get up and dance, 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 get up and dance. Say good morning to your friends. Happy Friday, everybody!
So they have so many great things coming up. They're going to be doing swim in our pool in the aquatics department. They are going to be doing Hebrew class with Miss Batsheva via Zoom. And we are instituting cooking classes once every 2 weeks in all of the classrooms. The teachers are very excited about that. We can't wait to see what the children enjoy and what they don't. And we're just moving forward with a great, happy, healthy school year with all of the kids. We're really happy to have everybody back. Right now we're outside one of our three-year-old classrooms, and the threes are really at the beginning of their academic journey this year. They are learning, starting to learn how to write their names and their letters, exploring journal writing, having the teachers write down their dictations of their pictures, and so many other amazing new things are happening in the threes this year. They're really starting to explore how they can use letters and their function, a word wall, talking to their friends, and all kinds of great learning activities and things are happening here. So these children are starting to learn everything that they will need to know moving forward in their academic careers, and we are really excited for them. So these are our toddlers. They're outside enjoying some fresh air and playing with sidewalk chalk. This spicy little one is just so happens to be mine, so that's why I'm holding her, but she's enjoying some coloring activities with her friends. All right, so behind us you can see our playground revival is happening. We are adding all new climbing structures for the four-year-olds. We are adding an outdoor classroom, and eventually we will be adding a trike track so that all of the children can rotate through the different playgrounds and really have a full outdoor experience for learning and playing and growing. Now we're outside of the Early Learning Center's office, and we wanted to just go over some of our COVID policies. So as you can see, all of the adults in the building are masked all day long. We are doing drop-off at the front of the building so that children are being brought down by staff, and no one other than children enrolled in the center and our current working staff are allowed past our security doors. We have reduced the number of materials in all of the classrooms by probably about 50%. And we have morning and afternoon toys, which are disinfected in the middle of the day and at the very end of the day. And our amazing maintenance staff is coming in every time the children are out of the classrooms and disinfecting all of the large materials. So we are continuing to keep the children happy, healthy, and safe. And we are looking forward to a great school year.
We'll be right back. Hi everybody, it's Tina again from the Suffolk Y-JCC Senior Center. Nice to see you all. I hope you enjoyed your summer. And as we jump into fall, we're going to be starting some new things as we roll out additional programs for you to enjoy. So look forward to two exercise classes that we're going to be starting again outside under our tent, specifically geared towards you. We're going to be starting again our chair yoga class as well as our sit and fit class. In addition to that, we're also going to begin doing some music and some speakers under our great big tent. So stay tuned, watch your emails, check in with us if you have questions, and we'll get you excited about doing all these wonderful things this fall.
Hi, I'm Nancy Braille, the Chief Engagement Officer for the Suffolk Y-JCC. I'm here today to let you know on Thursday, September 17th, we're going to be hosting our annual golf classic at the Tam O'Shanter Country Club in Glen Head. Our honoree this year is Seth Covey, and we're very excited to have him with us. He'll be joined by many of his friends, our committee members, board members, as well as Suffolk Y-JCC members on Thursday for a great day of golf, fun, and food.
We are introducing a new program for our school-age children this year. We are calling it Full Day at the J. Children can come here and do everyday virtual learning to go on to their regular school day, or come A Day, B Day, so that the days that they're not in the school building, they would come here, log on, and attend classes virtually and get all their school work done. They will also have the opportunity to participate in fun activities such as playing outside, playing group games, playing all sorts of board games, arts and crafts, STEM activities, very similar to a camp program. The program runs from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. with the option for before and aftercare. If you'd like more information about the program, feel free to call me at 631-462-9800 and I'm extension 114, or Ron Hayden can also answer your questions. He is at extension 120.
We're doing a beautiful concoction of all the expired food at my grandparents' house.
Raspberry walnut?
Okay. Oh. Thousand Island dressing?
Beautiful.
Cocktail sauce.
Perfect.
Who's got the shrimp? Cherry juice? Jacob, take a whiff. Come here. Chocolate milk mix.
It feels really chunky. Yeah.
Tabasco sauce. We have salt, we have tomato sauce, we have cheese.
Time for the 2012 dated gravy.
Hey everybody, it's Scott from the SYJCC Fitness and Aquatics Department. We're so happy to have been open since August 25th, and it's been great to see so many of you back in the fitness center. Right now you can make your reservations for the fitness center, the track, or the swimming pool. This week our outdoor group fitness classes have expanded to meet your needs, and we hope to see you back real soon. Now let's go inside to show you what we've done to welcome you back. All right, welcome to the fitness center. In this area, you see all of our cardio equipment. We've made individual cubicles that will allow you to work out, feel safe and comfortable for the full hour that you're able to do so in the fitness center. When you make your reservations, please know you either get an hour of a cardio machine or an hour of strength training. Each session runs 60 minutes, and after each 60-minute session, our staff spends 30 minutes sanitizing all of the equipment for your safety and our safety. We have a limited amount of reservations daily, so we ask you to make your reservations 3 days in advance so that you can guarantee the spot that you'd like. Throughout the fitness center, you'll notice that we have sanitizing stations, which includes wipes, disinfectant, and hand sanitizer. Throughout your stay here, we do ask you to please wear your mask throughout the entire stay and wipe down your machines prior to and after usage. For strength training, we also have limited space, so please make your reservation. Most of your equipment that you're comfortable using is still here. We've made it socially distanced, so you feel comfortable during your workout time. If a machine is not able to be used, it is marked with social distancing having the day off. Please abide by our rules to make sure that our safety and your safety is a top priority. It's been a great few weeks, and we hope to see you soon if we haven't seen you already. Please check out the SYJCC website to make your reservations, and if you have any questions, just give us a call. Looking forward to seeing you back real soon.
TACSY News.
And I'm Hope. Tonight we have live reports coming in from the Statue of Liberty. Juliana, are you there?
Hi, Huck. I'm here at the Statue of Liberty with Guinness Book of World Records holder Kaylee. Kaylee has walked backwards up the landmark over 500 times. Kaylee, tell us more about this accomplishment.
Well, one day I started walking backwards and I just couldn't stop.
Was it difficult to find time to do this?
Yes. My family and friends always thought I was crazy for canceling plans to practice walking backwards. But now that I'm in the Guinness Book of World Records, they're proud of me.
I know we were all rooting for you.
Thank you.
Back to you, Huck.
Thanks, Juliana. I can't wait to see your picture in the Guinness Book.
Me too.
Now we have Chloe with the weather.
Hi, Dara. We are going to have a pretty breezy week. On Monday, we see a 300 mile per hour wind speed, and then we're going to have some mint chocolate chip ice cream in the evening. On Wednesday, we are going to go to a brisk of a negative 125 degrees, but overall, it's going to be pretty clear. Thursday and Friday, we don't really see much change, the same thing. Then on Saturday, it's going to be pretty foggy. Oof. And then on Sunday, it's a 100% chance of salsa and chips. Get ready for a spicy weekend.
Thanks, Chloe. We're now getting a traffic report from Alexa. Alexa, are you there?
Good evening, everyone. Yes, I'm here in the traffic copter above Northern State Parkway. We have an accident between a scooter and a monkey. Prepare for a long commute home.
Thanks, Alexa.
Next on the scene is Olivia, live at the 2020 Met Gala. Olivia?
Hi, everyone. I'm here at the Met Gala with some of Hollywood's biggest celebrities and craziest outfits. Catherine, how are you feeling tonight?
Well, I'm feeling pretty tired, but really excited. I've been preparing for this moment for 3 years. I haven't slept since 2017.
Oh, wow. And what are you wearing tonight?
Well, I am wearing this one-of-a-kind ensemble provided to me by Kmart.
Amazing! Jacob, what are you wearing tonight?
I am so honored to be wearing this invisible tuxedo provided by Best Buy.
Amazing! And are the rumors true that you're providing a new Zydeco album?
Sorry, I can't let that info out yet, but you can definitely expect some new music coming from me soon.
Amazing! Alex, what are you wearing tonight?
Well, tonight I'm wearing a vintage suit from 1776.
Amazing! And where did you get it from?
A grave robber provided it to me to make sure it was really authentic.
Beautiful! Back to you, Huck.
Thanks, Olivia.
Wow, what an exciting night they have ahead of them.
We're now getting a breaking news report from Casey. Casey, are you there?
Hi, Huck. I'm here at the beach after a jogger called the police about a two-headed snake spider that washed up on shore yesterday. They've never seen anything like it before and think it might be the result of some biochemical explosion. At the moment, it's being taken to being studied. I will let you know if there's any more information that I find out.
Wow, thanks, Casey. Keep us updated.
In sports-related news, Nate was able to interview one of the injured ring toss champions of Long Island during their final match. Roll the clip.
So, Lauren, we're sorry to hear about your recent injury. Can you tell us what happened?
Definitely. At the end of the first round, the ring fell on my foot.
And how much did that ring weigh?
About 400 pounds. Luckily, it was only a hairline fracture.
Well, we wish you a speedy recovery.
Ouch, that's gotta hurt.
Our last story of the evening is sure to appeal to your sweet tooth. Ariana, what have you got for us?
Hi, all. Yes, I'm here with business owner Richie at the grand opening of the brand new frozen yogurt place, The Fast and the Frozen. Can you tell us about the new shop?
Absolutely. So we decided to open this yogurt shop because our first 15 close, and the 16th is the lucky charm.
Wow, that's pretty ambitious. What are you doing for the grand opening?
Free yogurt for everyone.
Oh, and tell us, what's the best flavor?
Pickle and stale cornflake.
Well, there you have it. Come on down for a complimentary scoop. Back to you, Dara.
Well, everyone, that's all we have for you this evening. Thanks for tuning in.
This has been Dara and Huck for TACSY News. Have a good night, everyone. This has been Dara and Huck for TACSY News. Have a good evening.
On Monday over here, we are going to have a wind speed of 300 miles per hour. Then,
I'm here in the traffic copter above the Northern State Parkway. We have an...
Catherine, what are you wearing tonight?
Well, I'm wearing this one-of-a-kind piece made by Kmart.
Awesome. And what have you been doing?
Sorry, I can't let that info out yet, but you can definitely expect some new inf...
I think it might be the result of some biochemical reaction. Oh, I keep messing up.
Guinness Book of World Records holder Kaylee. Kaylee has walked backwards up the landmark over 500 times. Was it difficult to find times? Kaylee has walked backwards up the landmark.
But now that I'm in the Guinness Book of...
Kaylee.
I forgot to tell what you did.
Luckily, it's only a hairline fracture.
Well, we wish you a speedy recovery.